back with Bobby and JJ Radio. We have someone very special. She's a third generation real estate agent. With that being said, top 15 teams of RE/MAX. We won't hold that against her. RE/MAX is top 500 in the state of Texas in 2019. RE/MAX Planning Club of 2019. This is Miss Danielle Prowse. I want to say thank you for hanging out with us today.
Thanks for having me, y'all.
So three generations of real estate. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah. My grandma was a teacher in San Antonio, didn't make any money. So decided she was done with it, started in real estate. And then my grandpa joined her a couple years later. They were a pretty solid team for the first 15, 20 years, and then brought my mom in 2000 or 2001. And the three of them were a pretty strong team for the first several years. My grandma retired, then my grandpa passed, and so my mom was kind of out on her own for a while, and then she suckered me into it.
Suckered. Happens to the best of us.
So you're on your mom's team?
I'm on my mom's team, yes.
So how's that work? How do you like it? How do you love it?
It's awesome. It really
is. She's listening in right now.
Yeah, so yeah, she is. I've never had a boss that will fight for me better than your mom
for
will.
Sure.
So, you know, it's tense because you're working with your mom.
What's great is most people come in and build a database. Well, you came into an existing business that, you know, grandma worked hard from the 80s, was it?
80s.
From the
80s. Yeah.
So that's great.
Yeah, I'm very lucky. We've had a lot of repeat clients. At this point in time, we're 100% referral. Mm-hmm. We haven't paid for a lead in I don't know how long. So it's been a very, very strong business. It's been very lucrative.
Well, JJ took over his parents' mariachi.
Yeah, it was very lucrative at first. I mean, until we lost our base. I'm just kidding. All right. So talk about, how many years have you been with your mom now?
So I'm going on just about 2 years, a little shy of 2 years.
And so Bob's seen this a lot with when it comes to new agents. The first 2 years are probably the toughest, right? Is that what you think, or top?
I'd say the first probably 3 or 4 years are.
Yeah. How have you adjusted, and what do you feel are some of the high points of your real estate career thus far?
You're definitely right. It's been very stressful because you don't know where your next paycheck's coming from. I came from salary to 100% commission, so that's been rough. But the biggest challenge has been to grow my own sphere of influence. I can't just rely on my mother's influence.
Sure.
When I moved back, I got my first listing actually before I got my license.
Right.
And that was pretty awesome. It was really just a great experience for me. I learned through a fire hose just hit the ground running. So that's been awesome. We've been giving out reviews to people and they've been answering, and we've had some really, really positive things, and we've gotten a lot of really great referrals this year.
And so, when you say you came from a salary job, what were you doing before?
I was in staffing, which is a fancy term for headhunting. I did engineering and pharmaceutical staffing as a recruiter, and then I did IT for a little bit.
So this is a completely different game.
Yes and no.
Was it always a plan, like eventually I'm going to do real estate, or was it?
No, she got suckered.
I'm going to do everything I can to not do real estate, and then here you are in real estate.
It was pretty much, I am going to do everything I can to not do real estate, and then here I am. My mom came to visit me and pointed out how expensive things are in the East Coast, how stressful my job is, how I never get vacation.
Where are you living at?
Raleigh, North Carolina. So she pointed out, you know, typically you always close the deal with real estate. You make your own hours, and your clients love you.
You got recruited at that point, right?
Yeah.
And so what do you feel like working with your mom? Like, so is this you two on the team? Mm-hmm. What separates you guys from the competition of the other 12,000 real estate agents out there?
Well, I'd say for one, she has the background and she has the experience to really guide our team in a very, very directed light. The second thing is we are all about consistency and customer service. The white glove experience is very important to us, making sure that every client feels like they are well taken care of. And they're taken care of by both of us. Mm. If one person's not available, the other person absolutely is.
And when you say white glove, like, give me some examples of how you go a little bit beyond the call of duty when it comes to from your clients.
For example, we had a client that closed from out of state. And so we made a point of going and checking on their vacant house every single day, twice a day.
Mm. Wow. You just got punked, Bob. Yeah. And That is different. Like, right. I think a lot of times it's transactional. And when you're at 100% referral, it can't be transactional.
Absolutely not.
And it's kind of like they're an extension of your family, it sounds like. Because I would probably only do that for my mom or something like that. That seems like, is that how y'all treat clients?
Absolutely. I've been very hands-on with all of my clients. We're very boots on the ground. I will provide them a database of contractors, roofers, plumbers, electricians, anybody you need, I've got them.
How important do you think that is to have that kind of them being able to lean on you for those outside resources?
I think it's invaluable. Otherwise, you have to assume that the Google reviews are correct.
Angie's List, whatever.
Exactly. Yeah, Zillow's normally. Numbers are right.
If it's somebody that you know that you trust, then they're going to take care of your people, especially if they don't live here or they're not from here. They're just pretty much just a shot in the dark.
Mm-hmm. Quick takeaway. Now with the third generation being in real estate, do you feel that you have this, like, candid advantage? Because how many different peaks and valleys have your family seen? Like, how many recessions have they gone through? Like, do you feel that you guys are just ahead of the game because you've kind of, in three generations of women and your grandfather, seen it all?
Absolutely. I think that a really big takeaway that we've gotten from my grandparents is to always be prepared. You pay yourself first, and by paying yourself, you pay your business. You have reserves in the account, and you make sure that you've got at least 6 months of reserves to keep your business up and running. And that helps you not be commission hungry.
Sure.
And it helps gives you that peace of mind that if something bad happens, if the economy does go down, if the market slows down, you're okay and you're going to survive through that. So I think that's been a really helpful takeaway from them. And then addition to, it always comes back. Right. You have to have that mentality that it's slow right now, but spring is coming.
I love it. For 30 years of experience in white glove service, please contact Ms. Danielle Prowse. Website should be up soon. It's prousesehouses.com, or you can call her 210-478-6821. Again, that's 478-6821.